The movie opens up with a young church father, Peter, and a doctor named Nelson, entering a room where a nun named Magalie has been kept tied to a bed. She's actually possessed by a devil named Balbin, which has completely changed her appearance. Peter stresses that an exorcism must be done, or else Magalie will die. He immediately calls his senior, Father Michael, and asks him for permission. However, Father Michael refuses his request, stating that he's just a beginner. Despite Father Michael refusing, Peter cuts the call short and decides to do the exorcism by himself anyway. After sending everyone out, Father Peter sets up a camera to record all of the activities during the exorcism. As soon as he starts to read prayers, Magalie's bed bounces in the air. However, she's been so greatly possessed that the exorcism has no effect on her. Rather, the devil starts to undress and seduce Father Peter, who tries to control himself and continue his spells. He tries to sprinkle holy water on her body, but it has no effect. Soon, Magalie makes herself half naked and starts to pleasure herself in front of Peter. As soon as she completes her deed, a demonic scream can be heard and Magalie falls on the bed. Peter approaches to check on her, but Magalie pushes his hand into her private parts. At this moment, Peter can't control himself and kisses Magalie. He then tries to get away from her, but it now seems like he's completely under demonic possession as his eyes turn yellow. The scene then fasts forward 18 years, where a prison guard is trying to collect the food plates from prison cells. He puts his hands into one of the cells, and a prisoner bites off two of his fingers. In the next scene, we're shown a normal Father Peter who has now started living in the countryside of Mexico. Ever since the incident, he's been guilt-ridden. He now distributes food to the poor and takes care of the orphaned children. One day, while he's distributing food, a mother approaches him and takes him to our sick son, Philippe, who seems to be suffering from a strange disease. After some time, Philippe starts to shake, so Peter brings him to a hospital. Inside the hospital, Dr. Nelson examines Philippe and tells Peter that four children have already died because of the same disease. He also mentions that they have not yet been able to distinguish the disease and its cure. Later, Father Peter goes to a church, and Dr. Nelson follows him. There, Father Nelson reveals that everything is happening because of him, as God is punishing him for his wrong deed. Dr. Nelson tried to make him understand that he was possessed when he committed the sin, but Peter still thinks that it was avoidable. He then decides to confess with Bishop Monsignor Balducci, as he thinks it's the only way he can get peace. Afterwards, Father Peter can be seen in front of Monsignor Balducci, where he tries to confess his sin from 18 years prior. When Father Peter is about to provide him with the tape he recorded, Balducci reveals that the whole Vatican town thinks of him as a saint and provides him with a check containing a huge amount for his orphanage. Seeing the amount, Peter changes his mind. In the following scene, Peter is in his room playing the tape and cursing himself for the sin he committed. Suddenly, he hears a scream coming from the church. He goes inside to find that the statue of Jesus has been removed from its place. He looks around and sees someone crying in a corner. However, when he approaches, he's shocked to find the demonic form of Jesus. When the demon tries to attack him, Peter suddenly wakes from his nightmare. Shortly after, Peter gets a call from the prison officer who tells him that something abnormal is going on with one of the prisoners there and that she especially wants to see him. Peter immediately goes to visit the prisoner along with Dr. Nelson. After entering the cell, Peter learns that the lady's name is Esperanza. Suddenly, she starts to talk dirty with him like Magalie did 18 years ago. It turns out that Esperanza has been possessed by the same demon that Peter encountered with Magalie. Later, Esperanza's mother arrives, and she turns out to be Magalie. She reveals that Esperanza is in fact Peter's daughter. Magalie then suggests that Father Peter save their daughter if he really wants to get over his guilt. At night, Peter is again haunted by the demonic form of Jesus, where he's unable to move his body. After that, we get to know that Philippe has died, and the doctors still don't know about the cause of his death. Following that, Father Peter visits Balducci and provides him with the report of Esperanza, asking for his permission to perform an exorcism on her. Balducci grants the permission, as he doesn't want his people to face any trouble. This time, though, Peter tells Balducci that he wants someone to assist him in this exorcism. Next, we see Father Michael arriving in Mexico as per the request of Father Peter. Father Michael is known to be the best exorcist in the whole world, as he's the one who previously defeated Balbán. That night, Father Peter burns the tape recording of Magalie's exorcism, and we are shown that Peter was actually possessed by Balbán when the incident took place. Father Peter also reveals to Father Michael that he's been seeing the demonic Jesus in his dreams. Upon hearing this, Father Michael suspects that Balbán is trying to possess him. Inside the church, a nun named Camilla is praying to Mother Mary when blood drips down on her forehead. She notices that the statue of Mother Mary has vanished from its place. Suddenly, she hears some unusual sounds and notices cloth lying on the ground. There's blood around the cloth, and when she lifts it, she sees a dead child underneath. Soon, the statue of Mother Mary starts approaching her, and it seems like she's possessed by a demon. However, when Camilla turns around, she doesn't see anyone, but shortly after, she's pulled away by a demonic force. Now, Camilla, possessed by the demonic Mother Mary, appears in front of children and tries to haunt them. Magali tries to stop Camilla, but gets overpowered by her. Hearing the children's screams, Father Michael and Peter arrive and save Camilla by expelling the demon out of her body. At the same time, Peter notices that the children have now also been possessed by the demon. In the next scene, as Father Michael and Father Peter enter the prison to perform the exorcism, the lights suddenly go off, and they find that Esperanza is missing from her cell. Elsewhere, Dr. Nelson is also checking on the prisoners when he finds that all of the prison cells are unlocked. Soon, he finds the corpse of the prison guard and becomes frightened. At the same time, he hears a girl crying, and as he tries to approach her, another possessed girl attacks him with a knife. After a while, Father Peter and Michael find Nelson in an injured state, surrounded by several possessed female prisoners. Father Michael reads the spells to free the prisoners from the demonic possession, but it seems to have no effect on them. Suddenly, the possessed Mother Mary appears in front of Peter and tries to haunt him. Then, the prisoners move forward to attack the fathers, but Nelson intervenes and stops them. In return, Nelson gets stabbed by the prisoners and gets eliminated. Taking this as an opportunity, Father Michael and Peter escape to a room and lock themselves in. Inside, Father Michael asks Peter about what sin he's carrying within him. He's asking because his prayers didn't work on the possessed prisoners. After Peter reveals that Esperanza is actually his daughter, Michael tells him that now it's impossible to defeat Balban and save the orphanage kids and Esperanza. Peter requests that Father Michael perform the exorcism and save the kids, but Michael replies that he's unable to do so, as he's already provided his soul to Balban when he saved the life of a child before. Shortly after, Father Michael passes away, but not before suggesting Peter to not make any deal with Balban. Right then, the possessed female prisoners break the door and storm inside. However, somehow, Peter manages to flee from there and hide himself in another room. After that, Peter records himself confessing the sin he performed with Magali 18 years ago. He then sends the video to Balducci. He then comes out of the room and confronts the possessed prisoners. Three female prisoners attack him, but Peter successfully stops them by reading prayers. Meanwhile, the demonic Jesus appears, carrying the crucifix on his back. He also tries to attack Peter, but Peter stops him with holy prayer. Suddenly, however, a possessed female prisoner attacks Peter from behind and knocks him unconscious. In the next scene, Peter finds himself tied to a chair. Just then, Esperanza, who's possessed by Balban, begins to read devil prayers to perform a reverse exorcism on Peter, aiming to extract God out of him. Because of this, Peter feels extreme pain, but he controls himself, and in turn begins reading holy prayer, making it difficult for Balban to perform exorcism on him. Meanwhile, inside the hospital, the possessed Mother Mary haunts Camilla and tries to kill the orphanage children. Back in the prison, Balban falls on the ground when Peter reads the prayers. As a result, the demon proposes a deal. If Father Peter expels God from his body, it'll leave Esperanza and all the other children. With no other choice left, Peter agrees. Shortly after, Esperanza faints, and the children in the hospital come to their senses. In the following scene, Father Peter takes Esperanza out of the prison and brings her to Magali. After that, it's shown that the media is portraying Peter as a saint, as he saved more than 112 children's lives. Bishop Balducci also arrives and informs Peter that he's deleted the video and that his confession is bound by a sacred seal. He also proposes Peter to work as a counselor in the Vatican, to which Peter agrees. At the same time, Esperanza and Camilla approach Peter and ask him to bless them. After Esperanza and Camilla leave, it's then revealed that Peter is actually possessed by Balban and that the bishop is actually under his control. In the last scene, Peter is moving towards the Vatican City, saying that the devils don't just want to inherit the kingdom of gods, but that they want to take over the whole earth.